That was Blues Magoos with their take on James Brown's I'll Go Crazy off their 1966 album Psychedelic Lollipop. This was actually one of the first albums to feature the word psychedelic right on the sleeve. Like, that's basically telling people, hey everybody, we like psychedelics. We're into weed. We're listening to that today because we have two songs from the Beatles coming up today, and one of them is from 1966. The other's from 1967, so this is just something that would have been around right around that same time. It's an American band, and they never really made it big, though, so who knows if the Beatles even heard of the Blue Magoos. I never heard of the Blue Magoos until today. It was an alright song. Might check them out a little more. Sorry, my clavicle is killing me. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 78 of the Beatles Tournament. If you're new here and you're not sure what a Beatles Tournament is, basically what we did was we took every single Beatles track we could find, threw them into a single elimination-style tournament, and then we make them face off head-to-head until we have a very best Beatles song left standing in the end. Now, we also have to play the songs in reverse with a bit of distortion, and that's just because of copyright reasons, but also, you know, I mean, it's kind of fun thinking you're in hell or you're listening to the Beatles. Am I alone on this? So first up, we have, this one will be real weird, backwards and distorted, Within You, Without You, which is another George Harrison song. We had a George Harrison song just yesterday, and it didn't win. Savoy Truffle was good, really good. I actually like Savoy Truffle better than this one, probably. This one has a lot of Indian influences. It was a big departure from earlier Beatles work, and it's a pretty long song. It's over 5 minutes, which for the Beatles is a pretty long song. He wrote it after spending 6 months with Ravi Shankar, who is an Indian sitar composer, sitarist and composer. He's known as a sitar virtuoso, and George Harrison was getting really into sitars right around that time. Next up is Dr. Robert, which is off of Revolver from 1966, and this one's actually a semi-autobiographical song by John. In an interview with Dave Sheff, he said, "Another of mine, mainly about drugs and pills. It was about myself. I was the one that carried all the pills on tour." So Dr. Robert was John. And Dr. Robert's a standard length Beatles song of just a little over 2 minutes. So let's just go ahead and get right into these songs and see which one sounds better. First up is Within You, Without You. Yeah.
Christmas Eve.
All right. That was just what I remembered exactly. It's a decent song. It's never been one of my favorites. It is interesting, though, that George Harrison is pretty much the only Beatle credited on here, at least on Genius.com. I really doubt that was Ringo on the percussion there this time. But yeah, I think there were no Beatles on that besides George Harrison, which is interesting. Kind of a bad choice not to include Ringo, if you ask me, but, you know, I'm biased. Let's go ahead and just get into Dr. Robert next, because I don't know how I feel within you without you. I just always have a trouble with that song. I like it, and I don't at the same time. Here's Dr. Robert. That's a pretty fun song. Definitely about drugs. You can tell Dr. Robert is just selling you whatever you need. He works for the National Health. Never mind. He's a good guy. Kind of a tough choice. Like, they're two completely different songs. There's nothing similar about them in any way. This one does have all the Beatles on it, which is pretty nice. I like that. That's right. This one's also on the Yesterday and Today, which has a picture of the Beatles covered in babies and meat. It's a pretty weird image to put on your pop group's album. Yeah, I think just being that I'm so on the fence Within, or I'm so on the fence for Within You, Without You. Like, it's just never been one of my favorites, and maybe it's because it's that type of song in the middle of a bunch of rock songs. I appreciate psychedelia, but it isn't the type of psychedelia that I get into. I'm more of an effects type of person. Like, I like to hear like what people do with amplifiers and guitar pedals and things like that, I guess, more. And I like electronic effects a lot. Just never really got into like certain aspects of psychedelia, I guess. Like, I'm not a huge fan of like folk influenced jam bands either, you know. Like Grateful Dead, a lot of people love Grateful Dead. Megan loves Grateful Dead, but pretty lukewarm on it at best. I'm just gonna give that one to Dr. Robert. It's more of a Beatles song for me. It's got all the Beatles on it, and it's one that I never had any problem with listening to in the middle of the album or anything like that. I've always enjoyed Dr. Robert. Within You, Without You, just, I don't know, it just never really did much for me. Maybe I'm the moron. Let me know if I'm the moron. I've got Instagram, we've got Facebook, and we've got Twitter. Make sure you hit us up on that. We've got TikTok too. That's going pretty well now. I will link the songs down below so you can listen to them in their entirety and without the distortion and backward, the backmasking going on. Like this video if you like this type of content. Subscribe if you really like this kind of content. You want to see some more battles with bands and, you know, tournaments and whatnot. There's other stuff I'm working on, but I've just been really busy with some personal life stuff, you know, getting a job and everything. But there is there's another review I'm working on, actually, that I need to finish up. I need to actually consume the thing I need to review first. Make sure you share this video with your friends and your family members, and make sure you share it with just your postman today. Or lady, your post person today. Make sure that they know that you think mail is great, and that the Beatles is great, and that band battles is great. I hope y'all have a... Oh yeah, also, comment down below with what you would have chosen out of these two songs. And that's it for today for the Beatles. I hope y'all have a great night, a wonderful afternoon, and a fantastic afternoon. Fantastic morning. I just said the same thing twice. I'll see you guys later. Sir, I was listening to you. Yeah, it was her mom.